In 1748, Prussia and Austria met on the battlefields of the War of the Austrian Succession. It would change the political landscape of Europe for centuries to come and ensure the survival of Prussia, later known as Germany. With no male heir, King Charles VI of Austria had to find a way to allow his daughter to succeed him without upsetting Salic law. His solution, the Pragmatic Sanction. In it, many European nations agreed to allow the daughter of Charles to ascend to the throne in exchange for various gifts. On October 20th, 1740, the Austrian king died, aged 55. His daughter, Maria Theresa, succeeded him. However, Prussia, France, Sicily, and Naples refused to honor their promise, and on December 16th, 1740, supporting the Elector of Bavaria's claim to the Austrian throne, Prussia and all her allies invaded Austria.
Naturally, Austria was like,
never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down.
Despite this, some nations respected the Pragmatic Sanction, coming to Austria's aid. These were the Dutch, Hanoverians, and Great Britain. At this time, the British were fighting the War of Jenkins' ear with the Spanish. So, when Britain sided with the Austrians, the Spanish joined the Franco-Prussian coalition. During this time, tensions were high between Sweden and Russia, as Sweden was looking to regain land lost to Russia during the Great Northern War of 1700. Tensions came to a head in 1741 when Sweden declared war on Russia.
This pushed Russia to join the Pragmatic Alliance, in turn forcing Sweden to side with the Prussians. The war was fairly short and ended in 1743, right after the conclusion of the First Silesian War in 1742, in which Prussia left the war with the majority of Silesia. In the absence of Prussia, the war instantly turned in favor of the Pragmatic Alliance. The anti-Austrian alliance was tearing at the seams, commanders resented one another, and offered little resistance to the Pragmatic Alliance's advances. This was made worse by the fact that Saxony turned on the allies, deserting to the Pragmatic Alliance. Worst of all was Bavaria's precarious situation. They were outnumbered and had little support from their allies. This all came to a head on June 27, 1743, at Dendington Village, when the Pragmatic Army surprised and crushed the Bavarian army.
Even so, the Pragmatic Army didn't exploit this victory to its fullest potential. Though the French and Bavarian lines were in complete disarray after Dettingen, the Allies didn't push the advantage. This gave the French and Bavarians time to reform and regroup. Things got even better for the French when the Botha conspiracy was uncovered. Essentially, an Austrian envoy was actively involved in a plot to remove the Russian Empress. However, both Sweden and Russia withdrew from the war at the Treaty of Abo, August 18, 1743.
Fearful that the Prussians would re-enter the war, Maria signed a peace treaty in the city of Worms with Sardinia. In it, Teresa agreed to give up all of Austria's lands west of the Ticino River in Italy. Some territory south of the Po River was also ceded to Sardinia. This would allow Austria to focus on one front should Frederick decide to invade.
Finally, in August 1744, Frederick II, apprehensive of the newfound success of the Pragmatic Alliance, renewed his own alliance with France and once more invaded Austria.
This seriously rocked the boat for the Pragmatic Alliance. Up until now, they had been winning the war. With the re-emergence of the Prussians, the tables shifted back in favor of the Pragmatic Alliance. Even so, Maria managed to secure a peace treaty with Bavaria before marching on Prussia, hoping to win several decisive battles and force Frederick to make peace. However, even with superior numbers, they were driven back by the Prussians. By December 1745, the Pragmatic Alliance was forced to sign a treaty with Frederick. The entirety of Silesia was ceded to the Prussians, though Frederick agreed to recognize Maria Theresa's husband, Francis I, as Holy Roman Emperor.
In August 1745, before the Treaty of Dresden, the British had yet another Scottish rebellion, this time in the form of the Jacobite Rising. Because of this, Britain was forced to pull back a good portion of her military to defend the mainland. However, it didn't take the Brits long to suppress the rebellion, and by April 1746, the Jacobites had disbanded after a decisive defeat at Culloden.